term cool was born of jazz. First came the attitude, then the music.
It runs all like that all the time. And so Buddy Bolden passed the baton to King Oliver. And he passed it to Louis Armstrong. He passed it to Roy.
Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie invented bebop. They turned everything expected of jazz on its head. Miles Davis himself played with Parker at the age of 19. But what would come next? Davis had an idea: to take bebop, cool it down, and render it, in his own word, sweet. In 1949, he gathered together a nine-piece band of like-minded players and arrangers. They were all disciples of Parker and Gillespie, but led by Davis, they would try and find a new sound. The results would later be called the birth of the cool. By the end of the decade, Miles Davis would bring the new sound to near perfection. Kind of Blue is as good as it gets. It's since become the best-selling jazz album ever. Its themes are familiar in bars, restaurants, and public places. It's part of the soundtrack of our lives today. The birth of the Cool Sessions marked the arrival of a new generation of musicians who would have an immeasurable effect not only on their music, but on the whole world of art and literature, an effect that's been felt ever since. The three arrangers on the sessions, Gil Evans, Gerry Mulligan, and John Lewis, went on to develop sounds as distinctively their own as Davis did himself. Lewis co-founded the Modern Jazz Quartet. Their name said it all. In 1949, around the time of the birth of the Cool Sessions, Miles Davis visited Paris. He and the singer Juliette Gréco fell in love. She was the muse of the artists and writers of Paris's Left Bank. She introduced him to the great philosopher Jean-Paul Sartre. The new jazz musicians identified with the intellectual freedom of Paris. Paris, in turn, lionized them. Parker, Gillespie, and Thelonious Monk, and the generation they inspired, presented their music as an end in itself. Until then, jazz had been sold as pop music, entertainment.
Down from a bloke in Chinatown. I think his name was Smokey Joe. And he used to hidey-hidey-hidey-ho, but now he's Zazu, Zazu, Zazu. With his Zazu, Zazu,
this new jazz didn't look back only to its own traditions. It didn't look exclusively back to New Orleans or beyond to Africa. It looked everywhere. It sought freedom. It looked to be taken seriously. More than anything, it looked to the future.